بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to today's lesson for the third intermediate grade, second semester for the book Full Blast 6. Today's lesson will be a revision for module 3 and 4. This lesson was prepared and will be presented to you by Faisal Rashid Al-Ghamdi. In this lesson, we are going to cover the following lessons 3C, 3D, 3E, 4A, 4B, 4C, 4D, and 4E. By the end of today's lesson, you should be able to identify reflexive pronouns, to identify some conversational phrases, to identify and write conditional sentences type 2, to read for specific information, to identify clauses of result, to identify some vocabulary presented in module 4, and to report commands and requests. Let's start with the reflexive pronouns. What are reflexive pronouns? Reflexive pronouns are the pronouns that you can see here on the right column here. They are himself, herself, itself, myself, yourself for the singular, yourselves for the plural, ourselves, and themselves. As you can see in this schedule, we can see the subject pronouns. These pronouns usually come before the verb. Object pronouns usually come after the verb or preposition. Reflexive pronouns also come after the verb or preposition, but if the subject and object of the verb are the same. So when do we use the reflexive pronouns? We use them as objects of verbs when the subject and the object of the verb are the same. For example, I am hungry. I'll make myself a sandwich. In this sentence, the subject of the verb make and the object are the same. So we choose the reflexive pronoun instead of the object pronoun here. We also use reflexive pronouns after prepositions, like in these two sentences. Don't worry about Phil, he can't take care of himself. I don't like Jack, he always talks about himself. We used the reflexive pronouns here after the prepositions of and about. Look at this sentence. He hurts me. The subject is not the same as the object. He hurts him. The subject and the object are the same. In this situation, I'm going to replace the object pronoun him here. Use the reflexive pronoun himself. So the sentence will be, he hurts himself. Note, we use by plus reflexive pronoun to show that someone does something alone without any help from anyone else. For example, my sister learned how to speak English by herself. That means that she did that without any help from others. Now let's do some exercises. Choose the correct words. Number one, I can't clean this huge place by yourself, me, or myself. Will you help me? Here we have the preposition by, which indicates that the speaker did that without any help from others. The speaker is I, so the appropriate pronoun here is myself. Number two, why don't you call Adam and tell him, himself, or yourself to come round? The subject in this sentence is you and the object is Adam. So the subject is different from the object. So I am going to choose the object pronoun, which is him. Number three, have you seen my sunglasses? I've looked for themselves, them, or they everywhere. Here I am going to choose the object pronoun because the subject is I and the object is them. Number four, how can Tina take care of a pet? Your sister can't even look after myself, her, or herself. Yes, the correct choice here is herself because the subject is your sister, which can be replaced by the subject pronoun she. So she take care or she takes care of herself. Number five, after you feed the cat, let it or let itself or let himself go outside for a while. Very good. Yes, let it go outside for a while. Number six, Karim and I found a solution to the problem all by ourselves, us or themselves. Here again, we have by. Preposition indicates that the speaker or the speakers here did that without any help from others. So Karim and I can be replaced by we. So the appropriate answer here is ourselves. Now let's do this speaking exercise. We are going to match the sentences on the left with the best reply for each one on the right. Number one, I can't do this exercise. It's difficult. What's the best reply for this sentence? Is it A, it's supposed to be a small house by a lake? B, I was so tired that I couldn't be bothered. C, I don't think so. It's a piece of cake for me. D, no need. We are going out tonight. E, because I can't hear myself. Or F, oh, you have a point. I forgot about them. The best answer here is very good. C, I don't think so. It's a piece of cake. A piece of cake is an expression that is usually used to say that something is very easy. Two, don't forget to attach the wheels. What's the best reply here? Very good. F, oh, you have a point. I forgot about them. Have a point means you are right. Very good. Number three, what does this painting show? Can you tell? Very good. It's supposed to be a small house by a lake. That is what we can see in the painting, in the drawing. Number four, I haven't got time to make dinner. The best reply here? Very good. No need. We are going out tonight. Number five. Why did you turn the TV off? The best answer here is? Very good. Because I can't hear myself. This is an expression that we use to say that there is a lot of noise. Number six, I thought you put your new bookcase together last night. The answer here is, I was so tired that I couldn't be bothered. Can't be bothered is an expression that is usually used to show that you do not care about something because you don't find it interesting. Let's move on now to grammar. We are going to talk about conditional sentences type 2. We use conditional sentences type 2 for unreal or imaginary situations and situations which are unlikely to happen in the present or future. Conditional sentences type 2, like any other conditional sentence, consists of two clauses. The first one is called the if clause, which contains the condition, and the second one is the main clause, which contains the result. The if clause should be in the past simple in type 2, and the main clause should have a bare infinitive preceded by would or could. Look at the two examples down here. If I had the camera, I would give it to you. Had here is the verb in the if clause. It's coming in the past tense, and the verb here is a bare infinitive give preceded by the word would. If they made more money, they could buy a car. Made is past, and here buy is a bare infinitive preceded by the word could. Note, in conditional sentences type 2, where is often used instead of was in the if clause in all persons. For example, if I were Larry, I would accept the offer. Usually we use was with I, but in the if clause in conditional sentences type 2, we use were. We use if I were you to express an opinion or give advice. For example, if I were you, I'd study harder for the exams. Here he is trying to give an advice to him by saying, if I were you. Now let's do some exercises. Choose the correct words. Number one, if the teacher found out about this, he will be, would be, or can be very upset. This verb is coming in the main clause. It should be preceded by the word would. Number two, if you will drive, have driven, or drove a little faster, we could get there by noon. What's the correct choice here? Yes, we will choose the one in the past. Which one is in the past? Drove. Very good. Drove. Why did we choose the past here? Because it's coming in the if clause. Number three, if I am, if I were, or if I will be you. If I were you. Very good. If I were you, I'd invite Tom to my house. Number four, if Gary ever went camping, he would find, will find, or can find it difficult to survive. Yes, very good. The correct answer here is would find, because it's coming in the main clause. Now expand the notes to make sentences. If I save money, be able travel in summer. Yes, if I, then the past tense of save, saved some money, comma, I would be able to travel in summer. Very good. If I saved some money, I would be able to travel in summer. Number two, Ted win competition if not be tired. Notice here that the if clause is coming second. So this is the main clause. Ted would win the competition if he was not or were not tired. Notice here that we didn't use the comma because the if clause is coming second. Read the situations below and write conditional sentences tied to number one. I'd love to make a donation, but I don't have enough money. Yes. So if I had enough money, I would make a donation. If I had enough money, I would make a donation. Number two, Jim never studies hard. That's why he doesn't do well in his tests. So if Jim studied hard, he would do well in his tests. If Jim studied hard, comma, he would do well in his tests. We usually use commas before the main clause if it is coming second. But if we have the if clause second, we will not use the commas. Now let's go to reading. And here we are going to read the posters coming about three fundraising events and answer the questions. Write A, B, or C. This is poster A. It's about a car wash fundraiser. It says, let's improve Riverview Park. Let's make a new playground. Let's buy and plant more trees. Come to the town car park. We offer a free car wash. All you have to do is make a donation. Friday, 23rd of May, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Bring your car to us and you will get it back looking brand new. Lots of soft drinks and snacks available. Interested in becoming a volunteer and helping us out? Everyone over 10 is welcome. Contact Mr. Dale and then he has his phone number. Poster B, secondhand book sale. Secondhand means used, not brand new. Do you like reading? Do you want to buy secondhand books? Do you have secondhand books you want to sell? Then you are invited to our book sale. When? Thursday, 22nd of May, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Friday, 23rd of May, 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. Where? Riverview Secondary School. Why? To help us raise money for a new gym. Who? People of all ages. Special events. Take part in competitions and win special editions. This is poster C and it is about a town bake sale. Do you care about the homeless? Then join us. Riverview Stadium, Thursday, 22nd of May, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Can you bake? Then bring us cakes and biscuits to sell. Can't bake? Then come and buy our delicious baked goods. Want to be creative? Then enter our competitions for the best recipes and win money for the homeless. Come and help us raise money for charity. Now let's answer the questions. If you wanted to help people in need, which fundraiser would you attend? Yes, very good. As you can see here in poster C, it says, yeah, you will help the homeless and raise money for charity. So that means it will help people in need. So it is poster C. Very good. Number two, at which fundraisers can people have something to eat? Very good. If you look at poster A, it says lots of soft drinks and snacks available. So this is A. And in poster C, it says, very good, come and buy our delicious baked goods. So there's something to eat here. Question three, which fundraiser raises money to help the environment? Excellent. It's talking about poster A. You can plant more trees, which can help the environment. Number four, which fundraiser takes place on more than one day? Excellent. In poster B, as you can see, it's going to take place on the 22nd of May and 23rd of May, Thursday and Friday. So the answer is B. Number five, which fundraiser gives you the chance to create something? Excellent. It's poster C. In poster C, as you can see, you can make something. You can bake and then bring the cakes and biscuits to sell. Number six, which fundraisers organize a competition? Very good. You can see here in poster B, take part in competitions and win special editions. And in poster C, it says enter our competitions for the best recipes. So we have a competition in poster C. Seven, at which fundraiser is there a competition with no prize for the contestants? Very good. You can look at poster C. It says win money for the homeless. So the money that you will get when you win the competition will go to the homeless. You will not take it. So there is no prize for the contestants. Now let's go to grammar. We are going to talk about clauses of results using so or such. The clauses of result express the result of an action or a conclusion. They are formed with so, that, or such that. For example, the house was so expensive that we couldn't afford it. It was such a beautiful day yesterday that we went for a swim. So what is the result that the house was so expensive, very expensive? The result or the conclusion was we couldn't afford it. What is the result or conclusion that it was such a beautiful day yesterday? It was a very beautiful day yesterday. We went for a swim. We use so with adjectives and adverbs. We use such with adjectives with nouns. So we have three forms. First one is using so plus an adjective or an adverb plus that. For example, the lesson was so interesting that everybody paid attention. Another example, he runs so fast that he has never lost a race. If you look at the two sentences, you will find after so, we have only adjectives and then we have that. The second form is using such plus a or an plus adjective plus singular countable noun plus that. For example, he is such a fast runner that he has never lost a race. So in this sentence, as you notice, we have an adjective and we have a noun. This noun is a singular countable noun. That's why we used a here. It was such an interesting book that I read it in one night. The same is happening here. We have a singular countable noun. But in this sentence, as you can see, we used an. Why? Because the adjective that comes next starts with a vowel letter I. The third form is using such plus an adjective plus uncountable or plural countable noun plus that. The teacher asked such difficult questions that the students couldn't answer them. This sentence is similar to the two sentences that come before, but the difference here is that we don't have a or an before the adjective. Why? Because the noun is coming in the plural form. Note that can be always omitted. For example, he runs so fast that he has never lost a race. I can say it in this way. He runs so fast, he has never lost a race. Now let's do some exercises. Circle the correct words. Winning the championship was so a great achievement or such a great achievement that the team felt proud. Here we have an adjective and a noun, so we are going to use such. Number two, Hasna is so nice that or such nice that everyone wants to be her friend. Here we are going to choose so because we have only adjective. Number three, Faisal drives so carefully or such carefully that he never gets into any accidents. Here I am going to choose so because I don't have a noun after carefully. Number four, it was so a good book, such a good book that it became a bestseller. I'm going to choose such because we have a noun here. Now let's do some vocabulary exercises. Complete the sentences with the correct form of the words in capitals. You see the words in capital written in green color. Number one, the blank said there would be a 2-hour delay. We are going to use the correct form of the word announce. Yes, the correct answer here is announcement. Announcement is a statement which makes something known to the public. Number two, this math's problem is blank to solve. I just can't do it. The word is possible. Very good. The correct form of this word is impossible. Impossible means not possible or not able to happen. Number three, I couldn't sleep well because the bed was blank. The word is comfortable. The correct form of the word comfortable is uncomfortable. Very good. Uncomfortable means not pleasant to lie or sit on. Number four, this salad is blank. Can you give me the salt? The word is taste. This salad is tasteless. Excellent. Not having taste. Number five, I need to join the gym. I'm really fit, unfit, very good, which means unhealthy, not healthy, because you do not exercise a lot. Number six, before going to the zoo, all the children were full of excitement, very good, full of excitement. Excitement is the state of being excited, happy, or having a lot of energy as a result of something happy that happened to them. Number seven, there are some blank discounts at that shop. The word is believe. Very good. Unbelievable. Unbelievable means impressive. Too good to be true. Number eight, would it be blank to ask you to take off your shoes? And the word is polite. The correct form of this word is impolite. Impolite means not polite or rude. Choose the correct word. You are looking very luxurious, smart, or enjoyable this evening, Anthony. The correct choice here is smart. Very good. Smart means nice, often used to describe elegant formal clothes. Number two, the ski instructor we had was very experienced, delayed, or minimum. The correct choice here is experienced. Experienced means somebody who has had a lot of practice or experience doing something. Number three, when the horse left the stable, cabin, or resort, I had to clean it up. The correct choice here is stable. Stable is the place where we keep horses. Number four, I'll try to pass or spend or make some time to visit Tom this afternoon. Well, the three verbs can be used with time, but which one is correct? The correct one is make some time. Making time means to organize your schedule in a way which will allow you to have some free time to do something. Five, if all the passports, hosts, passengers are on board, we can leave. The correct choice here is passengers. Very good. Passenger is a person who is traveling in a moving vehicle, but is not the driver. Number six, why are you shaking? Why are you nodding or pointing? I know you don't agree with me. Why are you nodding? Nodding is moving your head up and down, usually to say yes. Number seven, A, I poured into Saleh, bumped into Saleh, or tapped into Saleh the other day. B, really? How is he? The correct choice here is I bumped into. Bump into somebody is to meet somebody that you don't expect to see. Eight, we have no slope, behavior, or choice but to wait here for Dad to pick us up. The correct choice here is the word choice. Yes, we don't have an option. A choice is something that you can choose. Now let's go to speaking. We are going to choose A, B, or C. Number one, I'm sure I won't win the competition. What is the best reply for this statement? Is it A, it's a good laugh? B, don't talk nonsense? Or C, Don't waste time. The correct choice here is don't talk nonsense. Very good. This is an expression used to ask somebody to be reasonable. Number two, I have to get ready. A, take your time. We are not late. B, from time to time. We are not late. Or C, make some time. We are not late. Yes, the correct choice here is take your time. Take your time means to do something without hurrying because you have enough time. Three, blank. Then the answer is, were you really embarrassed? What did he say? A, I was unpleasant. B, I made a fool of myself. Or C, I was disorganized. The correct choice here is, I made a fool of myself. What does it mean? To make a fool of oneself means to say or do something that makes others think that you are silly. Number four, what was the question here? Was it, did you make a good impression? B, did you have a passion for it? Or C, were they familiar with you? The answer to this question was, yes, I think they liked me. So the question was, did you make a good impression? To make a good impression means to make others notice and admire you. Now let's talk about reported speech. And here we are going to report commands and requests. Commands are sentences that are asking for something. Like if I say, open the door or close the window. Requests, or sometimes we call them polite requests, are like commands, but they have a polite expressions or words. Like if I say, can you open the door or could you close the window, please? If I wanted to report a command, I will use tell or order. But if I wanted to report a request, I will use ask and then remove the polite request expressions or words. If the command or request is positive, I will change the imperative to full infinitive. And if it is a negative, I will change the imperative to not plus full infinitive. And then I will apply any needed changes. Look at the two examples below. Sit down, the teacher said. Sit down is a command. This is a positive sentence. So that's why I am going to use either tell or order, and then I am going to change the imperative to full infinitive. I am going to bring the speaker in the beginning, the teacher, then the verb I am going to use either tell or order in the past. So I am going to say told or ordered. Then I'm going to put the object. He was speaking to me. So I'm going to say, the teacher told me. Then I'm going to use the full infinitive, which is to plus the base form of the verb. So we have the base form of the verb sit. We are going to put to before it. So it will be to sit and then down. The teacher told me to sit down. Look at this example. Please, Sahar, don't be late, Amina said. As you can see in this statement, this is a polite request. So that's why I'm not going to use tell or order. I'm going to use ask. I am going to remove the polite request word, which is please. I'm going to do the same. But in this request, it is a negative request. Don't be late. So I am going to change the imperative to not plus full infinitive. I'm going to bring the speaker in the beginning, Amina. Then I'm going to use the verb ask in the past, asked. Then I'm going to bring the object, Sahar. Amina was talking to Sahar. Amina asked Sahar not to be late. Now let's do some exercises. Rewrite the sentences using reported speech. Omar, give me that brochure, please, said Khaled. Is this a command or a request? As you can see, there is the word please here. This is a request. So I am going to use the verb ask. So Khaled asked. Who did he ask? Omar. Very good. To give, not me, him, that brochure, please, will be removed. So the sentence will be Khaled asked Omar to give him that brochure. Don't push me, Tim. Mark said. So this is, as you can see, a command. This is not a request. So Mark told or ordered, who did he order? He ordered Tim not to push him. So Mark told Tim or ordered Tim not to push him. Now we are going to do the opposite. We are going to change the reported speech to direct speech. Number one, Edwin asked us to go camping with him. So as you can see, he used asked here. That means he is making a request. So what are we going to do here? What did Edwin say? Yes, he said, go camping with us or with me. Or maybe he said, come camping with me. Who said that? Edwin said to us. So go camping with me, Edwin said to us. Or I can say, come camping with me, Edwin said to us. Number two, Mr. Gibson told me to take a break in half an hour. So what did Mr. Gibson say? Take a break in half an hour, Mr. Gibson said to me. Very good. Take a break in half an hour, Mr. Gibson said to me. Great job. In today's lesson, we have discussed vocabulary presented in Module 4. We have done reading for specific information. We have done speaking and we have learned some conversational phrases. We have done writing, conditional sentences, and reported speech. We have discussed grammar, reflexive pronouns, when do we use them. We discussed conditional sentences, type 2, clauses of result with so and such. And we have discussed the reported speech for commands and requests. Here we come to the end of today's lesson. Have a nice day.